So someone asked me how he could get my TCP Flags dissector installed and running and seeing the result as a column. So I have the Lua dissector here. So I got it from my website, downloaded it and extracted it from the zip file. And then here I have a Wireshark capture file. So let's open it. Okay. So, and it's actually TCP, it's an HTTP request. And so we would like to see here the TCP status flags here in a column. And for that, we need to install the plugin and configure the column. So first you need to copy the file to the plugin folders. There are several places where you can do that. And we are going to do that in our personal plugin folder. So you go to help. About Wireshark. Here, you go to folders, and then here you have your personal plugin folder. Okay, double click this, like this, and the folder opens. Now, let me get that out of the way. Okay, so and now I'm going to copy the Lua file and put it here inside the plugins folder. Copy. Okay, I can close that. And now I need to restart Wireshark because plugins are loaded at startup of Wireshark. So let's close Wireshark, start it up again. Okay, and now you can see already that for the packets here, there's an extra line. TCP flag. And let's select this one for example. TCP flag, you expand it, and here you can see the flags AMP in this example. Now to see this as a column, you select this field, you right click, and then you select apply as column. And by doing this now, you can see the TCP flags as an extra column in Wireshark. And this is also permanent. So if I close Wireshark and open it again, it will appear again. So that's all that there is to it. If you want to remove it, this column, you just go here to the header, right click, and say remove column. That's how you remove it.